Actually, almost exactly what I need. All right. Get hype! Oh, I'm so excited to play this game again. It's been a long time. Let's see how much of it I actually remember. All right, we're gonna have a vote down. All right, nominations for Link's name go. I heard Lunk. I heard Lonk. Link, Lonk, Lunk, D-Rock. What else we got? What should we name Link in Link to the Past? You got any ones to nominate? You can go for it. D-Rock. This is an autonomous commune. Just name. It's a good one. McFly. Nil is a pretty good one. Of course, A goes without saying. Andrea thanks you from her napping point, Spikey. I think that's good. And Zelda, let's do it. Put her on a 2-minute timer. I think I forgot to add multi-vote, so you can only vote once, but go for it. See, vote 1 for Link, 2 for Lonk, 3 for Lunk, 4 for D-Rock, 5 for Name, 6 for McFly, 7 for Aya Freight, 8 for Nil, send Link backwards, 9 for A, 10 for Zelda, name him Cat Hype. Caught that one too late. Alright, now we got 2 for Lonk is in the lead. In the event of a tie, I'll roll a die to determine who we go with. Hey SSO, how you doing? We're doing a quick vote to determine what we're going to call Link in this game. We got 2 for McFly, 2 for Lonk, and 2 for Nil. I think it might be a random roll between those three. If you wanted to wrap it up, you can vote 3 for Nil. I think McFly's going to take it. Nil has one up. What was vote 6? 6 was McFly. You're right. I think McFly's going to take it. Yep, that was McFly. GG. All right, we're doing it. Let's go. Oh man, I'm so excited to be playing this game. This is my favorite Zelda title. If you're new to the stream, hey, I'm Marstead. I'm trying to beat every awesome game ever made live on Twitch. You can go to games.marstead.com to see a list of all the titles we've worked through so far, what we've already beaten, what's still on the schedule. One day a week, we set aside some time to play the Zelda series, and we're almost done. We've beaten, so far, Skyward Sword, Minish Cap, Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask 3DS, Wind Waker, Phantom Hourglass, and we just beat Spirit Tracks, and now we're on the last timeline, which you can kind of think of as, it's not really the canon timeline, but where all the original games were in, the Fall of Link. So that includes Link to the Past, the Oracle games, Link Between Worlds, Link's Awakening, Zelda 1 and Zelda 2. If you're just here for Zelda, it will return next week Friday around the same time. Otherwise, we'd be happy to have you for some of the other games we're going to play, like Phoenix Wright, Final Fantasy, Legend of Legaia. It's rad, we're gonna play it. Great opening to the game, too. Yeah, now we need a McFly audio attack just for this game. Angry. Pretty stoked. I do like the 3D Zeldas, but it's nice coming back to the roots. McFly is a good choice for this character, too. This was the first Zelda to be a prequel, and since then, it's like 60-40 that the game's going to be a prequel. Be shocked if they ever make a Zelda that takes place after Zelda 2. Take my sword and shield and listen. Teach him about the spin attack out the gate. Pretty sure my uncle is dead. That's who that was with the mustache. Now, I think that if you didn't get the lantern in the house, you get it here instead of the rupee. But I'm not 100% sure. I didn't know that you could light torches with the lantern for the longest time. It seems like a silly thing, but I don't think it's actually required for any major puzzles for a while in the game. When I was a kid, I was stuck on that. Man, get ready for my all-time favorite song in the Zelda series, Hyrule Castle. Love it, I love it, I love it. Dark World is number two after that, and then it's a bunch of songs that are tied after that point. I like all the different versions of this too. Yeah, right? All the Fast and the Furious movies are before Tokyo Drift. I like how some of them don't, they can't shield themselves. They don't deflect off their sword. Right. I guess it would be pretty tough to go beyond fusion. Metroid has this, yeah, Fusion's a really good game, I agree. Metroid has this desire to explain why Samus needs to earn her upgrades back again. And it's led to some really cool games like Metroid Prime 2, Metroid Prime 3, both are based on why does Samus not have her upgrades. Metroid Fusion, or if it's Peak. It's one of those, like, they don't need to do that. Like, what am I saying here? Mega Man does just fine. Just, like, mechanics are not the same thing as flavor. But just assume the players are going to accept the fact that they don't start with all their upgrades and move on with your life, you know? I'm going to say the map is not the territory, but that's an entirely different idea. Yeah. We'll do Fusion on stream eventually. I think Metroid Zero Mission's on the voting spreadsheet right now. Competing in the short games category. Decent chance to pull that one in. Once that one gets completed, we might just overrule the auction system and sub it out for Metroid Fusion. Boomerang! This game is perfect to me. Like, in the same way Super Metroid is perfect. Everything they did with the Super Nintendo of taking a franchise from the NES and readapting it for the Super Nintendo. Like, it does everything that Zelda 1 did well, but better. I guess the only thing you could argue is that it's not as non-linear. But when you get to the Dark World, you can pretty much go where you want, you know, with some weapons limiting you. That's a smart way to do it, too. I think that starting off very linear and then... Alright, I actually already screwed this up. Kid Marsted is ashamed of me. It's usually how I fight this guy. Good enough. I got the boss key. You're gonna recognize a lot of the symbols I have in chat badges are just pulled from this game. Boss key, the small key, and the various shields. Oh, I understand. Thanks, Kapora Gabora. Andrea was joking to my sister that she should go to PAX East dressed up as Kapora Gabora. And just have a sign that says, do you want me to explain that again? And they both answers say yes. Yeah, I agree, Spikey. I think this is the definitive Zelda game. This is the game that says this is what every other Zelda is going to draw from in some way or another. And we'll branch in different directions, but... That's probably the most apt way to put it. Zelda 1 has the basic form of an idea. This would be an interesting one to play, too. I'm sure that this game, people watch speedruns fairly frequently. We'll see if Phalanx ever pops in. He speedruns this. I think it doesn't really matter which way we go. I think they're both going to take us out to the front. Same speed-ish. Chunk. Get used to not having the boots. Final Fantasy V, really? I could hear that, I suppose. I think that 5 makes Final Fantasy a little bit more approachable. Like, you never have to grind in that game like you kind of have to do in 4. Platonic Zelda. How do you speedrun this? There's a couple. There's Glitchless, which is maybe 3 hours? Remember cracking up that speedrunners have a split name called Blue Balls. I've seen this for a couple speedrunners, but mostly Phalanx. And it's when you're fighting Ognim, whether or not he shoots a single ball that you can deflect at him, or a group of blue balls that you cannot deflect, is completely RNG. So it can add like a minute to your time on the run if you get an unlucky split there. Fortunately, it's not terribly far into the run, but I think it's the same thing for the second fight against him. It's tough to play through 4 just battle to battle without stopping. It's definitely doable, but it's not trivial, I would say. Look how quickly the game moves through stuff. Like, we go da-da-da-da, and we move on, you know? Word to Skyward Sword and Beyond, that's how you do it. Don't do a short cutscene, cut away from the action, just move on. So I can light these torches to be able to see in the room a little bit better. It also require me switching from the boomerang. Yeah, awesome, D-Rock, way to go. D-Rock's been doing, was it Earthbound that you completed? Earthbound speedrunning community is really cool. They're all very friendly. Yeah. I guess a lot of those were in 3 too, but the core understanding of those jobs was Final Fantasy V, I think I agree. I need another key. That dude dropped it. Yeah, 6-gun. I've heard that about Just Cause. Same thing with, like, I love that they have the little bombable wall there. She's like, oh man, I gotta come back here later. Same with Grand Theft Auto, you know? Oh, they patched out some of the major skips. Interesting. The skips can be kind of important to the speedrun ability of a game, so to speak. Even just sequence breaks in a glitchless run, or 100% run, I should say. I forget which one it is, actually. It's this one. Yeah, the other one makes snakes and bombs fall from the sky. I didn't know about that trap. If anyone knows, like, ways that you skip content in this game, what the major Link to the Past glitches are, feel free to share. Destroy the wizard before he destroys all of Hyrule. If the village elder is ascending to the Seven Wise Zone, maybe he can tell you more. I will mark his house on your map, but watch your every move. Castle soldiers are looking for you now. It's a cool concept that the soldiers are after Link now. Give you a heart container after the first section of the game. Also pretty smart, I think. That's an excellent first game to have played Goomba. I think this game kindled my love for video games. I had been playing video games since the NES. My first game was Mario Duck Hunt for the NES when I was like 2. 1989, I want to say. I had Zelda for the NES, and then this system came out, and it was just like, man, this to be my life. This is the criminal who kidnapped Zelda. Call a soldier if you see him. Okay. I think if you put some magic dust on this lady, she turns into a fairy. Yeah, poor loyal soldiers. I guess we knock them out, quote. Get a bunch of rupees in here, maybe we can pick up that first bottle. house used to be a hideout for a gang of thieves. His name was Blind, and he hated bright light. That becomes relevant way to hell later in the game. I think we can clear this on the first try, yeah? Gotta think about it. No, maybe not. Get two of them on the first try and then come back down. Yeah, it's 100 for the bottle. What'd you say your favorite was again, Goomba? Okay. There we go, that's what we should have done in the first place. Ba-da-ba-dum. LucasArts Adventures and Might and Magic. Nice. Super Mario World's a good choice, too. I probably played some, like, random Atari game. We had a family friend with an Atari. How could you go out through life without bottles? Hold it above your head. I felt the need to call that out. It was a shopkeeper. I think if you talk to that lady, it summons a dude, so we're not going to bother with it at the moment. I think she also turns into a fairy if you sprinkle dust on her. Bombable wall in there, but we don't have bombs yet. Although, I don't think you need to get a bomb bag in this game. Like, if you're lucky, you can just find some bombs in this area down here. I think that's correct. Bomb bag was a Ocarina of Time idea. Yeah. Interesting one. Let's then gate more of the content. I think we want to go in here, because I think there might actually be bombs inside. Not 100% sure on that, but about to find out. Satisfying sound effects in this. Mario 64. Nice. Got it. Got more bombs. Look at that. In fact, that's one of the main reasons to come in here. I think you have a pretty high RNG chance for the bushes outside this building to have at least one bomb in it. It's your place to suspect that you have to use them. There's a couple other places we know are bombable. There's one in here. We go down and talk to Sahasrara. How the hell do you pronounce his name? I need to see it spelled again. Oops. Sorry, I ran out of bombs before. Super Mario Brothers 2. Super Mario Brothers as well, I should say. Yeah. Where it's at. Some arrows that I can't use. Sahasrara. Ah, I can take that. Can't catch him yet. Too speedy for me. Hiding in the palace past the castle. I actually already knew that, and you can go there directly if you know about it. There's another bottle in here, I think. Maybe, possibly. Yeah. Two bottles. I'm gonna get a bug catching net, and we can have two fairies and then probably never game over in this game. Up. Can't go out because I'm sick. Caught this cold from the evil air that's coming down off the mountain. I think you can use that against Aghanim to deflect his shots. They reference that. There's a little Easter egg in Twilight Princess. This is really cool conveyance over here. You see the building on the right side. There's also, it's kind of noticeable inside the room too, but you're like, huh, I wonder if I can get in there somehow. Gotta get the net. There's another bombable wall down here. Don't think there's too much else for me to get in Kakariko at the moment. Do-do-do-do. Probably just rupees, right? No, oh, peace heart. Hopefully I don't remember that one as well. I think that's about all I can do for now. Maybe hunt some pieces of heart, but we're not going to 100% it. Alright, I'm going to go easterly towards the palace. Knock out the first dungeon. Ba-dum-ba-da-da. Now, I believe there's a kind of cheaty thing you can do up here later. You can, like, I remember doing this as a kid, actually. It's not even, like, a modern speedrun strat. Where you can get into one of these graves before you're technically supposed to be able to. Actually, I don't think it's that one. Yeah, we'll have to come back here later. But this one, you can get into early by abusing the Dark World portal. Hop back and forth a few times. We'll probably do it when we get there. I think that's where you get the invisibility cloak? Question mark? Lets you move over spikes without taking damage. A little arrow flipped into the grass there, kind of cool. I think we can get the magic powder. Ow. The shield pretty useful here. Go. Oh right, those guys always do that, unless if you stun them first. I think we have to bring her a mushroom from the Lost Woods to get the powder. Right. We're gonna do that. Great. Yeah, a lot of neat magic items that the game doesn't give you a ton of reason to use all the time. Absolutely. Like the Cane of Myrna, there's the two different rods. A lot of them are used in puzzles. You're being really confused as a kid. There's the bat that, like, makes it so your magic only costs half as much. But the way he phrases it, it sounds like he's cursing you, so I didn't think that it was a good thing. Man, look at the graphics on these Octoroks! Night Vihan, thanks for hanging out. Happy New Year to you. Honk, honk, honk. Need to get some money, so I'm killing dudes here and there. We're gonna need 500 rupees, I think, to get the Zora flippers later. Don't know if this is a fairy fountain that has regular fairies in it or just has a big one. Might just be one big one. I wanna find one that has regular fairies though, so I can catch them. Well, we're also full on health, so. Wasn't a total wash. We still have a bomb, which I think we need for now. Yeah, Vihan. Jump? Yeah, right? That freaked me out as a kid. I didn't get it. What's up, dude? It is I. Saha Srahla. Or Sahasrala. Sahasrala. Who will learn to send on the seven wise men? Why is a young man like you searching for the Sword of Evil's Bane? Let me hear who won the three pendants and can wield the sword. Of course. Sure. Bomb this guy. I found some chests, I found some chests, I found some chests. Hey, 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 hey. Let's turn the corner. Oh! Armos statues. A lot of the enemies that were really frustrating in Zelda 1 Return in this one. Some of them I don't think we've seen again. Like the centaur guys, they were in Zelda 1 were really frustrating. They're in this one and are really frustrating. And have the centaurs returned to later Zeldas? They might have been in Link Between Worlds, now that I think about it. They just do a ton of damage is the problem. Yeah, this is a cool idea. I know the centaurs are in this one. Those are only two appearances, though, I think. T teach us about buttons. Look at that conveyance right there. There's nothing for you to do in this room other than notice the button on the floor. Hey, Serp. Thank you for the donation. I appreciate that. Future dollars. Donate an almanac. Sports almanac. Nope. Nice dodge. Go up down here. Hey, Ben. Cat sitting in Andrea's seat there. I think they actually take damage from the boomerang Stealthos in this one. Although, I don't know, these aren't technically Stealthos, are they? Are they like mini Fulse or something? Because I think Stealthos are the ones that you need to destroy with the bomb. You have to knock them down and then you have to bomb their corpse, keep them dead. Ben! This is the only Zelda game I can think of where it's actually a very effective strategy to throw pots at things. But this game is the first one to have destructible pots, right? That's such a cool idea. And cuttable grass, the legend goes that they didn't have cuttable grass in Ocarina of Time, and like, because it doesn't really fit, right? And like, the first people to playtest it complained and said, "This is Zelda, why can't I cut the grass? Part of this game is landscaping, come on." Use the treasure hidden in this palace to defeat armored foes. Cool. Maybe we want to do it. Because I think two people previously had voted for it, like the votes don't decay over time, sir. Rocked. And we need the big key in order to open the chest in this one. It's kind of a nice addition. I feel like they've removed that feature since Link to the Past. It certainly is complicating. Like they keep streamlining that. There's no the word compass anymore in most modern Zelda games. They just go with the map only. I think the challenge should be making the compass interesting, not getting rid of the compass. But in most Zelda games, both the compass and the map aren't particularly exciting. Not always true. The map is pretty cool. They found a cool way to use it in Skyward Sword. Like when you're in the desert levels and the map shows you what it used to look like in the past. Gray Stealthos? Gotcha. That movie had too hype. He just sitting there staring at us. That's how Ben do. Weirdo staring. Oh shit. Time up poorly. There you go. Perfect. They rely a lot more closely on this one, on the when in doubt, kill all the enemies in the room solution to puzzles. Orange Stealthos and Stealthos Knights. Stealthos Knights are the ones that you have to bomb when they're on the ground, yeah? Be my guess. Got a shortcut. You recognize this room because you've been here before. Great dungeon design in this game. I like just the volume of secret items you get in this one, too. It doesn't make sense to have tons and tons of items in, like, say, Spirit Tracks. Especially since you have limited design space with the stylus. It was kind of cool to have so many back in the day. Hint becomes relevant! Rocks. Don't need to light any of these. We'll go ahead and kill these guys, though, because money is always good. found some rupees. I found some rupees. I found some rupees. Hey, 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 hey. I hate these things. They drain your magic if they touch you in addition to damaging you. Doing alright on rupees. You need like 148 more to be able to buy the Zora slippers. As a kid, I was dumb. I would just like constantly run into the tree that's in Kakariko Village because it drops 5 rupees. So I would grind them out. I don't think you really need to do that. This game gives you a decent number of them. This was before Zelda started to be bad about giving you way too many rupees and nothing to spend them on, like Ocarina of Time. First try. Some of these buttons are fake. Yeah, that's what it is. Anti-fairies, that's... Don't remember. Is this one? Top left. The last one I checked. I do like this approach to dungeon design. Like, the... As much as I like the puzzles in Phantom Hourglass and Spirit Tracks, it's set up more in a way that, it feels like all the rooms are much more contiguous. Like, you're fighting the whole dungeon. Whereas in this kind of design, although a lot of the Zeldas mimic this, like, each room is its own challenge on its own. You're rarely taking something from one room and bringing it to another. There are a couple exceptions to that, and it's usually done pretty interestingly when they do it. Come on. Oh, sure. I'll be able to delegate that task in the future. Fork. There you go. Sure, sure. Oops, got too excited. It's 3, I think. Pro strat is to hit them all twice. But the last one has 2 points of damage on it. Gets nastier. Hooray! And they get over this pretty quickly. Like, we'll celebrate for a second. That's about all you need. Quick second of celebration. On the pendant of courage. Take it to Sahasrara. There we go. Sahasrara. Da-da-da-dum, ba-dum. Shiggity-dum, ba-dum. Shiggity-dum. Cool. Ben, are you trying to eat the New Year's beads? Have you stooped to this? This back on. Three or four generations ago, the Order of Knights protected the royalty of Hylia. Knights of Hyrule were also guardians of the Pendant of Curd. Unfortunately, most of them were destroyed in the Great War against Eva that took place when the Seven Wise Men created their seal. Right, so this is important. In Ocarina of Time, in this timeline, Link failed. Like, he tried to stop Ganon, but he failed, so the Seven Wise Men were forced to seal him. And there is no hero anymore. So there's this Order of Knights that shows up that tries to fight evil. They get wiped out. So we're descended from the Knights of Hyrule, not from Ocarina of Time, the Hero of Time, Link. You actually see a similar theme in, what's the game? Twilight Princess, where there's no Link around to stop Ganon. Adult Link defeats Ganon in the future and then gets sent back to be Kid Link. He goes on his little adventure in Majora's Mask, but I guess he tips off Zelda to the fact that there's this nasty Thief Gerudo guy. We see the cutscene in Twilight Princess that shows that rather than Link defeating Ganondorf, the sages defeated Ganondorf by sealing him. Sort of similar here, except the sages become the wise men. Hit those. Not right in the center. It's not ideal. Ow. Yeah, right? Like having the Pegasus boots. I was pushing myself to press them. Oh yeah? That's awesome, six gun. I like that as a sequel premise. That's pretty cool. Especially when it's a game that's, like, particularly hard. Escape. Okay. Not gonna try our luck again. One of these little mini-games gives you a, piece of heart if you do it correctly, I believe. I was stuck on this forever. Forever as a kid. It's one of the few games I actually owned. So I afforded to be able to be stuck on this for, like, probably months. I don't know why it didn't occur to me to run into the bookcase there, but when I finally figured it out, I was so excited. Yeah, Roxfeather in a 3D game would be really cool if they did it well. I think that we overlook how genius it is that in Ocarina of Time, jumping is automatic. That's just really, really, really smart. I guess they kind of do something similar in this one when you jump from ledges. But keeping that system and it working as smoothly as it does is really cool. A lot of games have borrowed that since then. I don't think Zelda would work with a jump button in 3D. Mm-hmm. I was supposed to run at that one. Don't be reading the sign. Alright, 14 seconds. Good enough. Let's go. Two brothers. In a van. No. Oh, that's right. One of the worlds you go to, I think it's the Dark World, like, you can piss off those trees when you run into them. Oh, yeah? Oh, I didn't know that. Today I learned. Bombs out, perfect. Right? Grandmas. Some berries. Pretty sure I was stuck here too. Where the thing you do in the light world affects what you do in the dark world. It took me a long time to figure out how to get into the water dungeon. It all seems like second nature now. You've played this game a bajillion times, but I don't know how many of you remember back to when you first played it as a kid. All right, let's release this. There's a piece of heart we can get from doing that. If I were a tree, I would be mad as well. That's reasonable for us. I think I can agree. We can be in agreement on that subject. I think, if I remember correctly, there's a cool little Easter egg here with the fish. I can pick him up. Oops, wrong button. There we go. Poor fish. When you first played this game, I think he's existed. Take some rupees, but don't tell anyone I give them to you. So this is, they should have translated this as, it's a secret to everybody. Yay, I got some rupees. Cool Easter egg. Yeah, so I think we're gonna be good to go for the Zora's flippers. The rate we're progressing right now. What's up, dude? Pay no attention to the average middle-aged man standing by this sign. It's a very Japanese way to phrase something. He does matter later. He's not useless. Now, part of it's like I'm trying to figure out, was I just a really dumb kid? Or was it that I was a kid that made it harder? Occam's razor, dumb kid. Let's turn the corner. Hey, what's up? Not at all, Sahasrila. Book of Medora. With it, you can read the language of the Hylian people. I see you. God, that's so satisfying. They haven't really pulled off that satisfying tap to see if it's a bombable wall thing since A Link to the Past, I think. Oh, wow, that's awesome, Fraff. Da-da-da-da! Awesome. I got a heart container. Make a prayer and your wish will be granted. Yeah, that echoing sound, the difference in the tink-tink versus tonk-tonk. You need the book, if you haven't played Link to the Past before, you need the book to read this, because it's an ancient Hylian, and you wouldn't know how to progress otherwise. Yeah, see? Happy New Year, sneakers. For some people, they're already in the future. Serp and Goomba. Already 2016. Don't break pots. Mustn't. Beamos. Remember which direction to go first in this one. Figure it out. Have your antlions. Yeah, so here's one where I played through a good chunk of this game without knowing that you could light those. But I think it gives you like a... the compass or something like that? Maybe not. I'm just there for funsies. Oh no, you have to use it to finish this dungeon. That's why I was stuck for so long, because I didn't realize that those were torches, braziers. I've already learned this technique. You must never fail to find all the treasures in each dungeon. Okay. Yeah, I have to wonder if they made that a praying scene just so they could use the cathedral sound again. Since you're in the cathedral so briefly, but it's a cool effect. I need to get the big key first. Nice, sneakers. It's a cool example of when, like, the sound design can influence the game design. I'm nearly 100% certain that the reason that there's a big opera scene in Final Fantasy VI is just because Uematsu wanted to write an opera. It ended up being really cool. I That's a bullshit room. Yeah, right? Not a lot of games do that anymore. I don't remember how cutscene-y Link Between Worlds is. I think that should definitely be a design goal when you're able to do it. It's sometimes easier said than done. Ow. Good enough. There's a big key. We got the glove here. Oh. Run. This one will go by pretty quick. I don't think we'll beat it next Friday, but we might come pretty close. Just because I know the game pretty well. This is probably the Zelda I've played more than any other. I'll get stuck for a while, I think, on Link's Awakening. That's one where there's a couple things that the game doesn't really broadcast to you, and if you don't just remember how to do it, you might get stuck for a while. So I'll rely on chat to help me out with some of those parts. Ow. Here, I don't cover all these, see what they are. Nothing particularly exciting. This one just gets right into it. Don't leave the house. And Zelda's, like, talking to you telepathically. We have a while before I need to get the Zora flippers. I don't think I need them for the next major area. Do anything? Probably not, right? Pushing one of these might do it there. There it is. That's a really cool secret. Aha! Perfect. I like the look of the fairies in this game. Probably the best. The way they look in Wind Waker is distressing. It's just calling attention to the fact that you're keeping these poor things in a bottle for the whole game, like how the villain does in Super Mario 3D World. Remembering where pieces of heart are that are trivial to obtain. I like that this dungeon has you go outside for part of it. I don't think so. I was expecting that to happen at the beginning of Undertale, Six Gun. Character tells you to stay in the room. I was like, I wonder if I stay here for a while. This is the kind of game that would actually make something happen, but I don't think it does. It does it in Stanley Parable in a couple places. Right. Red rupee. Is this one fire? No, not this one. Don't think these can have hearts in them. That didn't look like it. Yeah, this is just one where there's nothing else to do in this room. There's no Sahasrara to give you a hint. You just have to kind of figure it out. So, me not knowing that these were braziers that I could light, I was stuck for a while. It might have been good to have a sequence earlier in the game that kind of forces you to use the lantern, but I get why they didn't do it. Since this is the first game to have, you know, torches you could light. Bit of manga for Link to the Past, that's awesome. Don't know what the correct speedrun weapon is to use against these guys, but I've always used bombs. Hit multiple. Almost out. No. Seen different versions of this boss show up. Certainly the flying sandworm is a kind of a Zelda staple. Last one, he gets nastier. Shoots dirt in all directions. We'd already damaged him enough. Right, Spikey? It becomes such a Zelda staple after Link to the Past that sometimes you light torches to progress through a room. This is the first game that had that as a mechanic, really. Picking up rocks, moving along, let's go. I think I'm strong enough to pick these ones up, I believe. Could have gotten a bunch of rubies out of that guy, I shouldn't have killed him. Oh well. What do we got down here? Secret to everybody? Check out the cave east of Lake Hylia. Strange and wonderful things live in it. Don't know if we can... We might be able to do that. Oh, we can go check it out. Hey, we've got enough rupees. I miss the age of weirdos living in caves, giving you ideas. Giving you money. Don't think this is anything. Yeah, right, Spikey? I've noticed that sometimes. Like, really? Is this... Doesn't seem like professional writing here. Is there a bombable wall up here? No. I think there is in Link Between Worlds, though. There are a couple bombable walls in Link Between Worlds that aren't marked, obviously, in any way. You're just supposed to know that they're there because you remembered them from Link to the Past. I don't think any of them are necessary to beat the game, but it's kind of a nice little call-out. Get some more bombs eventually. Try killing dudes. Hopefully one of them will drop some. Whoa. Something's doing damage to us. Marstead's hubris, apparently. There are certain... Like, the game actually goes out of its way to tell you sometimes about ways to dork with the RNG. Like, I think that if you freeze an enemy and then destroy it with the hammer, there's a much higher chance that it will drop a... I need to focus for a second. But it will drop a magic meter thingy. Hopefully one of these is a fairy fountain. Those are rupees, not fairies. Earn a lot of rupees by defeating enemies. Secret to my success. Thanks, dude. Really helpful. Still need to get a... another bomb, though. Efficient landscaping. I think we might be able to get the ice thing as early as this. We just have to have a bomb we can use. This one's a fairy fountain if we had the bomb for it. Too bad. So sad. Buy some later or something. Cool, we'll come back here. Yep, gonna get the ice wand. I don't really have the MP to waste on it right now, so. That one either. Good night, Serp. Thanks for hanging out. Happy New Year. Playing Link to the Past for another 10 minutes or so, so we're not going to beat the next dungeon, but I think we'll get to it, maybe start it. There's another heart. There you go, Link. go. You can sometimes get bombs from those guys on the roof. They're more likely to drop them. Hey, convenient. Yeah. Yeah, they give you a little bit of wiggle room, but it's pretty tough. Another one you're talking about. It's the one that we can't do anything with yet. We come back later after they've left. Yeah, we'll come back later. Woodsman. Here we go. Friendly old man who's not at all a bad guy. Here he is. Can you go up the mountain? Will you take me with you? I lost my lamp, so... Poor guy, this, like, old dude just been sitting alone in this nasty cave full of keys. Turn right. Many people have vanished looking for the golden power. Don't get too involved in such a mad quest. I do what I want. Turn right. I have a granddaughter who's your age. The king took her to the castle, and she never returned. Ah. Guy's a heir to these sages. Old man can't run. Missing maidens are still alive. I believe the hero will rescue them. I wait for that day. Dangerous time, and I talk too much. Thank you for your kindness, an old man like me. I wanted to give you this. If you wander to a magical transporter, gaze into the mirror. This is a cool way to give you a thing that both has utility, just in general for the game, and has a story purpose. The magic mirror lets you exit a dungeon, so it lets you pop back out to the entrance. It's not its primary purpose, but it's something you can use it for. It's kind of cool. I like that it just throws it to you in the middle of the main story. It's not something you get in a dungeon. Yeah, right? Aw, man. Dark World hype. Not the best Dark World with the cool music yet, but... Link is a bunny. What do you want? You have to say to me, silly rabbit? Tricks for kids. I'm going to get the power globe. Now I'm a freak and I can't go back to the real world. If only I had the moon pearl from the Tower of Hera, I could go back to my original shape. Got good reason to be stressed out, so back off. Where are you, Mr. Bunny? The world is like the real world, but evil has twisted it. Golden powers would change your shape to reflect what's in your heart and mind. So he's a bunny in his heart? I always change my mind so I turn into a ball, but if you have a ball called the Moon Pearl, you can keep your original shape here. This cool conveyance up here. Like, you as the player aren't entirely sure what to do. You have to kind of pay attention to figure it out. Or you just look and notice how there's these kind of conspicuous little diamonds here, right? Hooray! Really, really like that secret. Tower of Hera, let's go. See how far we can get in 6 minutes. Probably not very. I really like the boss of this dungeon, too. They're pretty cool, though, right? Give you a hint that that's where you should stand. I'm trying to figure, like, what's... Guess you have to go there in the light world. Notice how much higher it is. Your attention is drawn to the piece of heart too, I think is another big piece of it. How you're supposed to figure out where to go. Like, oh, where's the piece of heart in this part? Fight these guys again. Yeah. Muldorn has returned in several ways to later Zelda games. Triforce Heroes. So here's a dungeon that's already kind of playing around with the idea of the boss key. You get it almost immediately in this one. I gushed pretty hard about Okami as well. That game is really, really good. Yeah, you should have seen some of the Undertale gushing. There's actually a pretty funny post on the Twitch subreddit today warning people against playing Undertale about how the fan base is a little bit too rabid right now, and they'll get really nasty to you if you don't, like, notice every secret Easter egg or, you know, pay too much attention to chat during an epilogue sequence. It is a really good game to play on stream if you haven't yet. Your Undertale blind playthrough is a limited resource that you have as a streamer. So if you have the mods to watch chat for spoilers and the thick skin to deal with people being difficult, it's definitely worth playing, I would say. I thought the post was funny, though. Ouch. There's another one. Fortunately, they've taught us this mechanic now. Sort of. We've been forced to use this mechanic to progress, so now we know what it is. Boss key, I think? Yeah, that's a ticket. Yeah. You guys are nasty. You can't hold the bow in this one and, like, strafe around. Shit, I gotta remember that not very few things actually do a half heart of damage to you in this game. You have to be really careful. I do have two fairies, so it's not the end of the world. So I'll try to avoid taking damage unnecessarily. Ah, crap. Hold on. Go back downstairs. Bastion is a therapy game. Bastion's really good. I never actually beat it, though, which is one of my great sins as a gamer, so it'll be fun to play through it. Finish it. Half a heart shy of an annoying beeping sound. I'm trying to be cognizant of the extra bombs. I'll take it. They're running low earlier. It's a cool way to teach you about the whole star on the ground moves the holes mechanic. Using it in conjunction with the colored switches. I'm gonna go ahead and assume we're gonna leave it on red for now. See what happens when we step upstairs. We're actually about 70% of the way through this dungeon, so I'm gonna go ahead and finish it. It will take maybe an extra 5 minutes or so. You gotta go up a floor and then drop down to get the moon pearl, and then it's the boss fight. I don't think... Can you beat this? I think you could beat the boss without getting the moon pearl. You don't want to. You won't be able to progress further in the game from there, but it's technically possible. Never played 7 or Symphony of the Night? Symphony of the Night is an amazing game. I made everybody play it. Oh, so these are the... When people were talking about bumpers in Mario Maker, I thought they were talking about these things. Just my brain, when it heard bumpers, this is what I associated them with. I guess the ones that they actually have in the game are different. These are unique to Zelda. Come on. There we go. Okay, hit this guy. This one can be kind of tricky to figure out. There's a rule in this game where if you see the mode 7 like grid below you when you are looking at a hole, it means you actually physically fall there. And it takes you down a floor. Otherwise, if you just see blackness, then you take damage if you fall. All right, boss time. This boss can be either really fast or not. We'll try really hard to do it carefully. And once we get the last pendant, we'll sign off, find somebody who's playing Zelda, preferably Link to the Past. If you guys would, please do tune in to Stimpy's stream. We chat a little bit earlier. He's going to be going live at 8 o'clock. Here we go. Rares. You fall here, you have to start the fight over, which is why they have all those hearts up top. In case you keep failing at it. No! They give you some room to not fall into the hole if you start to get knocked into it. Just how life worked out, KV. Have you since played them? I think we all have our gaming sins. There's an accepted canon of amazing classic games, and no one has had time to play through all of them. It's the thesis of the channel. There's too many awesome games to play them all, but we're going to try. Usually do spin attacks. That's an interesting strategy. Alright, let's go with... I'm going to go ahead and create a restore point here. Looks like Zelna is streaming. X-E-L-N-A. Let's pop over. Give them a little bit of a boost here. Thank you, everybody, for hanging out. Have a happy new year. Just a reminder that the new Sphere Point system is being deployed tonight at midnight. I'll be updating all of the documentation, updating the commands. Everything's going to be changed to reflect the fact that now the voting spreadsheet is going to be split into two, one that's 30 hours and higher games and one that's less than 30 hour games. So they're not competing with each other anymore. Keep an eye out for that. If you are a subscriber on Patreon, you might want to dump all your Sphere Points tonight using the mass voting tool in the spreadsheet. Other stuff coming up tomorrow is Phoenix Wright. I don't think we're going to beat it tomorrow. We're like 20% of the way through the fourth case, and there's still a very long fifth case after that, but we'll come fairly close to it. Saturday morning, we're going to be playing some Ogre Battle, and then next week, Monday and Tuesday, expect to see some Legend of Legaia. I think we're going to beat Legend of Legaia next week, Monday, Tuesday. After we beat it, we'll sub out for the next 30-plus hour game on the spreadsheet. Next Wednesday, it might just be all Mario Maker. If my 3DS hasn't fixed itself by then, I can't do any 3DS multiplayer games for a while until I resolve it, so it might just be Mario Maker next week. Next week, Thursday, will be Phoenix Wright, and if we beat it, Dead Space, at the rate that it's showing up on the voting spreadsheet. And then next week, Friday, Link to the Past will return. Thank you all for hanging out. I'm going to go ahead and throw up the away sign as we get host over to Zelna. Good night. See you in 2016.